Hey, everybody, welcome back to GDPG.
Hey, guys.
So, we're back.
We are back.
And you haven't noticed any time pass, and that's a good thing, because we took a short break. It is a week later, and we're picking up exactly where we left off.
We are picking up exactly where we left off.
Which is right at the very end of this game.
See, my mojo's gone. This is what I was talking about.
So, prior to the recording, Gigarius was practicing to rebuild his mojo. I'm not sure how we're going to cut this yet, but...
Yeah, I definitely lost my mojo again.
Yeah, we could probably include at least a little bit of the footage from our last capture. This is like... I feel like the designers knew that this is definitely the most difficult part of the game, is writing these platforms. And of course, they made that the most difficult... Or they like, really used that in the finale. Nice. I think you're in the next zone.
Oh my god.
All right, here you go.
Woo. Oh my god.
There it is. Here it is. This is what I've been waiting for.
Oh, what's this? Nope. Sorry, we're done.
I totally did the same thing when I played it too. I was like, I gotta see what else there is.
All right, Pancho, you're no longer a Panchito.
You're full-blown poncho now.
Poncho, man. You are a poncho. Oh, whoa, what?
You're a poncho, I'm a poncho. We're all a poncho.
So is this where the story gets, like, thrown out there?
I never put the ice pack on the camera. Yeah, that's right. We have an ice pack on our camera.
It definitely does not help. Fuck.
There you go.
Fuck.
Damn,
okay.
Again.
No, I'm not. Nope.
It's okay. Write it. It's going in.
How far back did it take me?
Not very far.
Oh, God. How do I get back up there?
Not that way.
No.
No. Oh, no, Tony.
Yeah, so, there's probably something still good in there somewhere.
Yeah, just after episode 10, or part 10... Gigarius and I sat here for maybe, what, an hour and a half?
Oh, dude, it was...
And you were just, like, you were just being tormented by
this level. I was livid.
And you're good at that jump now.
Yeah,
so...
I'm good at that jump now, but now it's everything else. Like, I'm just getting myself all mixed up.
Is it the third jump up there?
Yeah, I don't know. I just, like, I go backwards and I mean to go forwards, and it's...
Oh, it's the controller syndrome. There you go.
I forgot which way we were. It's not so much that, like, I didn't forget which way we were going. I just hit the wrong key.
Yeah, we've talked about this already, but with the gamepad, it's really, really hard to remember which direction you're going to travel, whether you're going in or out.
And even after all these hours of playing...
It still isn't intuitive, and that's why I think this game is actually best played with the keyboard.
With the keyboard, I would
Which is
agree.
Really unfortunate, because platformers are really not meant for keyboard. So it's like, I want to play this game with a gamepad, but it just doesn't want to work with me, you know?
Yeah. This is my problem. Like now I'm psyching myself out. I'm psyching myself out, audience. That's what I'm doing.
Don't psych yourself out, man. You got this. Look at that. You almost... Hey, you caught yourself pretty well there.
Yeah, well...
There you go. Focus. Boom. Boom jam. There you go. Boom jams.
Boom jams.
Look at that.
But in
the
now
last
I'm in a
recording,
really weird position.
In the last recording, that part took him about an hour.
That part took me way too... Oh, I was so mad. I can't get up there, though.
You gotta wait for you gotta get to that on layer one somehow.
Yup.
Shit, dude. Yeah,
There's
I don't know if you're gonna be able to do
I
that.
Can do.
Oh, that sucks. Well, there you go. There you go. There you go! Dude.
Thank God.
Dude, you're already bossing this.
Forward is right bumper, right? Because I'm about to fuck myself over.
I don't know.
Fuck myself over.
Okay. Remind me. So left bumper goes.
Left bumper
toward layer
goes
three?
Toward layer. Hold on. Yeah, left bumper goes towards layer three. If we're calling layer three the back layer.
Yes, and right bumper brings you closer to the front layer. Yes.
Layer one. Oh yes.
Okay.
Yeah, left. Yeah, right bumper brings you there.
Okay, man. I'm gonna try to help you by.
I know. I'm just.
So, okay, right here is where you're pushing right bumper, right?
Yep, I'm okay. Pushing right bumper now. Pushing right bumper again.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to try to help you.
I'm pushing left. I'm pushing left. Left goes back, right goes front.
Yes. So right, right.
Right.
Or no.
Nope.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, right, but not right at the moment. That's the problem, people. We took a week off and my brain went into like, hey.
Sorry, buddy, but your brain was already there.
Yeah, I know, dude.
I was there for 2 hours watching you go,
dude. That's okay, nice of you to
yeah,
say.
There you
to,
go. No, what was why'd you do that?
I don't know, because I hate myself. It's going to become a problem. I'm already psyching myself out.
Dude, you got this. You're already talking before we started recording how, like, you can't do it. You're just going to hand me the controller.
Yep.
But I believe in you, man. I think you got this.
I hope I have it,
but,
like...
You can't let down our audience. They're all they're all cheering for you.
I hope they're cheering for me. Or, yeah, that might be the unadulterated booze. I didn't say boobs. I said booze. In case everyone like, oh, boobs aren't so bad.
Follow it.
Fuck. I tried to follow it, but
should've
I had to
said
jump.
Right.
No, you're good, man.
So, okay, here's a game design-ish question for you. No.
Shit, I always fucking do the... No swearing. I won't swear.
Yeah, now that you're an official GDPG member, I can yell at you for swearing.
Yeah, I should've told me that during the South Park game.
Yeah, well, at the time I didn't realize how bad it was.
Dude, it was bad.
It was pretty bad. I'm pretty bad at it, too.
Yeah.
I'll admit it. Okay, so game design-ish question. As far as level design goes, since you've played through pretty much... No, hold it. Then jump and do right bumper. There you go. Now do left. Now... Oh, shit. Do right. No!
Yes, that's the bitch of it.
Yeah, we can't jump up there when it's on layer 3. Okay, wait. Follow it to right bumper. Okay. No.
Nope, fuck.
You gotta write that one out.
Yeah, no, I didn't jump far enough either.
Oh.
My jump was super shallow. Okay, be weird.
So, do you think that this little section kind of breaks the standard of the design
levels
have set so far?
In a way, yes. I just feel like all of a sudden we're having to watch everything. Like, now all of these pieces that we didn't have to worry about before have become an issue.
And I mean, there have been some levels where we saw similar design like this, where there's a large, climb up to the top and there's a lot of moving components. But I feel like this definitely penalizes you more than...
Oh god, more than
And it requires so much more precision. I think that's the better way of looking at it.
I think precision is the better way of looking at it, because it does.
And, it's a good way to make it challenging, right? It definitely made it more challenging, but at the same time...
It just, it makes me, I don't know, I just feel like all of a sudden the challenge went up, or maybe I was just on such a hot run, I didn't realize it.
There you go. Now...
I gotta take
follow
a
to right bumper.
Shit. I forgot what level we're at. That's my problem. I forget what level we're at, and it's really dumb, and that's just is more of a flaw with me as a gamer.
Well, it's also really easy to forget. There you go. Jump and hit, yeah, there you go.
There you go.
Now go up.
Okay, so right bumper. So that's my problem. I'm just getting, I just get myself so psyched out here.
So, okay, I've been thinking about this too since we last recorded.
Yeah.
I remember how we were saying, it's really hard to tell both, maybe, which direction it's going.
Well, colors help, but, I mean, I know for you, colors wouldn't make a difference.
The colors help, but here's the thing, though. The colors also don't totally help because when it's in the distance, it gets faded, and it actually becomes a lot harder to see the color. So I think what it needs is a number. It needs to see a 1, 2, or 3.
Ah, 1, 2, or 3, and that way you know.
And then maybe even, an arrow, right? Okay, there you go. Now jump up and hit left bump. Well.
I'll just go back with... Oh, right bumper goes back, right? No, left bumper does. No, what am I doing?
Fuck. I was going to say, it might be beneficial to have just hit... Yeah, there you go. Okay, yeah.
But now we're stuck.
Are you on layer 3 or 2?
I'm on layer 3.
Are you? Wait, no, you're fine. Hit, jump and hit right bumper.
Oh, because it'll just go forward me.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
Boom. There you go.
Dude. And I have to hit the right bumper again.
Yep.
I'm just...
Okay, jump on that. And then wait for... Oh, it's probably going to time poorly.
Yeah, I'm just going to jump down for a second. It's fine.
Oh, actually, this might be... No. Nope. There you go. Jump. Left bumper.
That works. I'll take that. I will take that.
Yeah, finally, the glitch death kind of helped you.
The one time.
You know what this also could have used?
I am just totally psyching myself out.
Maybe had they, like, established this as sort of a checkpoint area, I wish there was kind of, like, some way of turning on a switch or something.
Yeah, you know.
Maybe you could turn on, like, an instant kill.
The problem is they didn't have that mechanic beforehand.
Yeah, but here's the thing. Okay, so every level should probably... Oh, yeah, jump and then run to the right. Yeah. And now if you jump to the right and hit right bumper, see that thing on layer one?
Yeah, it should
come. That's going to come to you. You're going to have to time this well. Well, you're going to... There you go.
But now I have three.
Just let that kill you then some more. So, like... Well...
Didn't kill me more.
Oh, because it was on two, and then it moved to three? Oh, well,
that sucks.
Wow. Okay, so what I was trying to say was, every level generally should introduce a new mechanic, right?
Nope.
And so I think this area could have introduced, like, an instant kill switch.
True.
Or even, you know what this game I think really could benefit from? I think it would really, really benefit from a relay, like, oh, nicely done. Well, almost. Follow it, almost.
I'm getting better at some parts, and I'm getting a lot worse at other parts.
It happens. There you go. And now it'll follow you
up
forward.
And RB goes, no.
RB. There you go. And then right bumper again. Ooh.
Dude, I don't know why I'm like, literally, I don't know if any of you guys have ever felt this before, but all of a sudden you're at a really intense part in the game, and you're like, oh shit, I have to do this in order to fucking succeed.
Mm-hmm.
No, it's not gonna work. And all of a sudden, all the mechanics of the game just fall out of your head. Now, I don't know if any of you have ever had that before, but terrible feeling. Okay, if I jump back again, no, it'll be only two.
You're going to get blocked by that top
one. I need to go...
So we're going to wait for that bottom one...
To come all the way back. No, second layer.
Maybe second layer. I think it'll be okay in the second layer. Okay, so what I was going to say, I think this game... Actually, I'm going to shut up for a second. Okay, jump on that. Now jump up. And left bumper. Quick. Now run. We're going to actually have to follow that one...
The big one?
The big one.
And when it comes back?
So then jump and...
Hit RB.
Jump and move to the left and hit right bumper. There you go. Now follow it for... Yeah, just follow it.
My only problem is this one's so slow that I'm worried I'm going to mistime this. Because, really slow this one down.
When it starts flashing, it always is the same amount of time when it starts flashing.
Yeah.
It's just getting to that point where it starts flashing that changes everything. Alright, and now you probably can just, like, jump up and go left bumper. There you go.
But
and now jump and hit right bumper.
No, but that's how it's two.
It's on layer two, but you're on layer three. So you can jump up there and then
and then jump back.
Yeah, exactly.
So right
just
bumper.
Don't let it kill you. There you go. Now jump up. Boom.
Okay,
and,
I think... I can't see anything.
You can just jump across. Yeah, there you go. And now jump and go to layer two with right bumper.
Should I jump there, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
There you go.
That's right. Oh, I feel like you're just talking me through this, though. I shouldn't be doing that. That's some poor gamer. Poor gamer, guys. I swear if you watch the rest of this series, you'll see, he didn't do that bad. I mean, Chris was here to help me out through a lot of it, but I swear I'm not that bad. Okay, this is where things got bad.
Okay, focus right now. Mm-hmm. I'm going to do the talking for a little bit.
Yeah, I know.
I don't have to respond. I just want to, like...
I know, but I just have to figure out how the fuck I'm going to do this again. I think I have to jump. Oh, I have to jump, get in that middle space, then jump on the next one?
Yeah, so you're going to jump on that, and then I think jump up. If you look on layer two...
I'm on layer two.
On top. Oh, so then layer one. Yeah, okay, so on layer one, you should be able to jump up there. So jump
from the second block. Yeah, I don't have to move over.
From there, now jump and hit. Yeah, there you go.
Okay.
Now you can jump on that block.
Right.
Wait for it to go to layer two, though.
And then, because I can just jump on that second
and then you can jump on that other.
I'll wait a second. We're talking. Well, why don't you talk? Okay. Why don't you talk design for a minute?
Okay. And, so I think one mechanic that this game is severely missing that I think would help fix a lot of these.
Oh no! 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 Okay, that's not bad.
Woo.
Oh, wait, is it bad?
No. You can jump and go to layer two.
Oh, layer two. Yeah. Wait.
Okay. No. Never mind. Go back to layer three. And then move to the right.
I think I need to redo.
No. You're fine. Now jump and go. Now go to layer two.
Oh, yes.
There you go. So I think one mechanic that would make the design of this game a lot less frustrating and more fun is having like a relay point. Like you can drop a respawn point so that say like you know say right here if you were to drop a little flag, if you were to fall, being able to teleport back up to that flag
would be nice.
Would be amazing.
So here's my question, because I have to go back a layer, and so I have to get that to the third layer, jump up and hop up on top of that tall guy, yeah?
Okay, here's what you can do.
Mm-hmm, I'm trying to see.
Follow that one cube all the way to layer three.
Yeah, and that's like, I'll just be going back, so left bumper all the way.
Yes.
That's all I gotta remember, fucking left bumper. Wait, we'll go one more time forward? No.
So jump in left bumper. Jump in left bumper. Now jump on that. There you go.
That's right. And
now
then
from
just
right bumper. There you go.
Okay, now can I jump up on that without a problem? No, I can't.
Oh, maybe not. So go back to that platform behind you.
Yeah.
And now jump up and then hit right bumper over that taller pillar.
Oh, I'll make that?
Yes. Oop, too much momentum. Jump and do right bumper. There you go. And now.
Oh, wait a second.
Yep, left bumper. And then jump, left bumper. There you go. You just gotta line up with that. You're giving
it
too much momentum.
I'm giving way too much momentum. See, now I'm like overcompensating for all the issues from before. Nope, fuck, I'm gonna wait. I'm just gonna wait. I swear I'll stop swearing. If you did a Tony swear count, it would be astronomical.
And that's why I don't do a Tony
swear count. Yeah, you really shouldn't. I get frustrated.
Okay. And jump. There you go.
I don't need that much momentum. So
don't need much. There you go. Now one more.
I have to wait. Oh.
There you go. Okay. Now follow this up. Wait for it to come to you. There you go. There you go. Okay. Run. Okay. Follow it. Left bumper. There you go.
Right bumper.
Right bumper. Up. And then right bumper.
No. Where am I? No. Okay.
Whoa,
no, we're good. We're
Tony,
good. We're
you're
good.
Stressing
we're
me
good.
Out,
we're
buddy.
Good. We're good. So I just have to jump across.
No. Go to the right.
Oh, right
go
bumper?
Right. No. Just go to the right.
Oh, right there. Yeah, that's right. Da-da-da-da-da.
And then right bumper.
Oh, dude, I'm stressing myself out.
Okay, so this area is pretty good.
Well, except one time.
But I think that only happened when you flailed and you.
I just started hitting like, all the bumpers. I'm like, ah, come on, we can do this.
Okay, jumping right bumper.
Well, not yet. Left bumper.
Oh, shit. Now I'm getting mixed up. Left bumper.
And now I want to do a little right bumper.
There you go.
A little right
bumper.
There
you go. And just let that come.
I'm just gonna wait a while.
Let it come to you,
buddy. This video is super long.
Yeah. That's okay though. Okay, left bumper. All right, climb up. Stay there. Right or left bumper. There you go. Climb up. Red bumper. All right. Ride this one out. Don't jump yet. There you go. Right. Oh.
Nope. Oh.
I guess you could have just, like, landed on that
one. I could have just landed on that one. Oh, that's so
funny. If you hit left bumper.
Except I did hit left bumper, and I...
Had you hit right bumper or nothing,
I would have been fine. How dumb is that? How dumb am I?
That's the thing about this game, though. It's so easy to make those little mistakes.
And this is where playing on the gamepad does get harder, but I just did not want... Because it's already kind of in my body.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't want to switch to keyboard, because there is still a whole new set of mechanics.
Yeah, you'd have to reacclimate to it.
It'd
take too long to get used to it at this point. There you go.
In this part, no problem now.
Before you know it, you'll be at the end.
And then it'll be like 18 sessions in, and we'll have like a Zestiria run on our hands.
Oh no. Right bumper? Oh no, shit, it went the other way. Sorry. There you go. Okay, now right bumper. There you go. And No. Why do you keep hitting left bumper?
I don't know why I keep hitting left bumper.
Don't hit left bumper there, man.
Dude, I'm getting so... I'm so in my head right now, dude. I am so in my head. But I'm not going back to the beginning. That's not happening.
Don't hit left bumper.
I know. Left bumper is like... Because I don't know. It's just so nice.
Wait. Left bumper?
I know that part I get.
I know. But now I don't trust you anymore.
I just need to ride that last one out. Just need to ride that last fucker out. Should be left bumper.
Yep. There you go. And yep.
Left bumper.
Up. And then right bumper.
Right bumper.
There you go. Do not hit left bumper. Just jump. Just jump. There you go.
Then I have to left bumper here though.
Left bumper.
No. Oh.
Shit.
Oh.
Okay, well this... No!
No!
Why'd you do that?
Where the hell am I now?
You're on layer 2.
No, but...
Just jump up there.
Ooh. I am getting ballsy. That's not good.
Okay. Okay, right bumper. There you go. And jump. There you go.
And left bumper?
Right bumper.
No, yeah. And left bumper
now
here.
Now it's left bumper. There you go. There you go. All right, left bumper.
Again. Yes. Are we there? Yeah, are we there?
I think you did.
I'll stop. Okay.
No. Just keep going.
No. We need to record.
We're still recording.
No, the video.
It's going.
It doesn't say record, does it? Oh my god, it does. Holy shit.
Doing, buddy?
Oh my god.
That's how focused he is. Dude, I think you did it. Okay. Just let that come to you, and now.
No, I'm waiting. I don't care.
Jump up there.
No, I'm waiting. I am going to wait. I don't care. I am nervous.
Go up.
No, I'm waiting until it's all the way here. Okay, great. And then I have to hit what left?
Right bumper.
Oh, right bumper. Oh, is it easier if I don't think I can.
Just right bumper and then right bumper.
Just right bumper and then right bumper. Oh, because I have to get to that next area, the front.
Yeah, it's right there.
Oh, I'm getting myself up there.
Yes, it's right here.
So
man.
Right bumper,
this isn't
right
even
bumper.
A challenge. Just jump on there, go to right bumper, and then right bumper, and now go up there.
Oh.
There you go. You're fine. You got this. Okay, now jump up and do left bumper.
Will that actually take me there, though?
Yes. Now go inside. I think. Yeah, there you go.
Oh, Jesus.
You were scaring me at the last part.
Dude, no, because I was...
You fell at that point.
Oh, no.
Oh,
did we do it?
We did it. It's not totally done yet.
But no, but there's no more jumping.
The challenge is done. Well, the physical challenge is done.
Dude, don't do this to me, man.
The physical challenge is done.
Wait, is there like puzzles now? My god, you're really here.
What does that mean?
I don't know.
What?
Nope. He's like, come over here, child. I have a poncho too.
I have some candy into this poncho.
It's you. I am sorry. I am so sorry, my son. Ooh. Oh, you said the robot son. For everything I did, I don't deserve forgiveness. What did you cause the apocalypse? I don't have much time, but I'll try to tell you everything I can. Oh, dude, this is so worth it. This is so worth it. I am so excited. It was me. It was all me. Centuries ago, it was I that unleashed the calamity and destroyed the world as we know it now. No, wait, calamity. We have to drink.
Oh, God. Don't bring me back to Zestiria.
It was supposed to make the world a better place, but something went wrong. What, Papa? What went wrong?
But why?
This machine has kept me alive all these years so that one day I could reverse my mistakes. This is intense. However, it's only temporary. Oh. When you were built, your memory was wiped.
Oh, no. Oh, yes.
But know this. You are my son, my real son?
Oh, yes.
After the calamity, I couldn't let you disappear with all the others, so I had to change you, and in so doing, I made you a part of my terrible mistake.
I turned you into a robot, son.
Holy shit. You're no longer human, but I did make you special. You have something none of the others have. A poncho. He has a poncho.
Oh, it's better than a poncho.
I get it. You have my heart.
Why do you think he needs a machine to live?
I had to find a way to keep us both alive while I tried to create a new machine, one that would save us all. I feel like making more machines is not a good idea.
I don't know, man. Machines are what brought us here.
It was the only way, and now I'm going to give you a choice.
Oh, yes.
my heart is the key to everything. Give it to me and I can release myself from this machine and reverse the calamity. Oh no. What's option B?
I think you already know.
But without it, you will die. If there was another way, I'm so sorry. Let me live to finish my machine and I can save the old world, or you can live and survive in this new world without humanity. Sorry if I said that really quiet.
Oh, you did. But it was a dramatic moment.
I don't have the right to take the heart from you. The choice is yours. No. No!
I told you.
Oh, who made this? Was it Delve? Is this Delve?
Delve Interactive?
Fuck you, Delve!
Whoa.
That's the one F word I'm throwing out here of the seven I've used already. That's a good choice, man. You have broken my heart. After breaking my spirit, you've now broken my heart.
What's it gonna be, buddy?
So do you walk up to it and bounce on it? Or do you just...
You just move toward him or away from him. What do you do?
But if you make the one movement, will it automatically select it?
Maybe. So be careful.
Here's the thing. All right, guys, I'm going to get real here. Pancho has been doing all of this for some reason, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I've always believed, I've played so many games where I feel like at the end of the day, the best thing the hero can do is give their heart for a better cause. Now, what I'm scared of is that Delva is going to pull a gut punch... And my father isn't going to really reverse the calamity, and things just get worse. This is what I'm worried about. So here I've had cute little Panchito this whole time, my little buddy. We were some hard times. Chris, now is a good time to play back all the times I failed. You know, it was the good times, just not making that jump 45 times. So do I continue in this world?
Of pain and suffering?
Or do I finally give it a chance to grow? But there's been so much beauty.
Do you risk
you know?
It all? And is it all so bad? Is it really all so bad?
I mean, really?
It's kind of beautiful in its own way, right?
Yeah, this world is beautiful in its own way, but then you have all those machines that are like, I don't understand life and numbers and things.
They can tell something's not right. Something's
yeah,
not
something's
normal.
Off. I wish I could just, like, phase in and out and just die. Just not give them the heart. Just nothing happens. Just phase...
Left bumper, later, bitches!
Later, motherfucker! And they're just back down to the beginning, and you're like, shit, this is a terrible idea.
There's no exit.
I am actually having a really tough time with this. But it's the hero's journey, and a hero would do something for the greater good.
And really, the question becomes, what was the point of all of this if you say no at this point?
Right, you're just selfish. Saying yes... I swear, if Delve just gut-punched me, though, I'm gonna be so mad. And that means I'll have to play this all over again just to get this darn other ending. Oh, Panchito.
It's actually really easy to get the other ending. You just hit continue, and then you start right here.
Oh, so we see both of them?
Okay.
I'm sorry, my son. I have my freedom, and I can save everything now. Psych. But I never wanted this. When you were born, I never thought this would be... how it all ended.
Kind of wish the text had a little bit of a back so it's easier to read.
Yeah, for everything I did, I don't deserve forgiveness. Maybe this is my punishment. I just wish that we could have spent more time together. You will always be remembered for what you did for this world. I love you all. No way. Ugh. Wow.
It's a pretty satisfying ending.
Wow.
It's a grim ending. Incredibly grim.
I don't want to see the other ending.
No, we don't have to.
I don't want to. I'd rather not know.
I respect that, actually. I mean, ultimately, I think both endings kind of have their own piece to them. Like, it leaves you feeling resolved in some way.
Oh, they built a shrine to Pancho. Of course, creepy trench coat guy's there. Or wait, or they like destroy Pancho. Yeah, the guy who's like, ah. Oh, what?
They were people.
They were all people.
Much like how you were a human child.
I don't know why I didn't think about that.
Yeah, that was kind of what a lot of their dialogue kind of alluded to.
That actually
that
really...
It makes sense why they...
die?
No, I think it's just like time passes.
Oh.
But yeah, I think that's really what a lot of the dialogue from the robots is that they feel that something's not right, something's not natural about what's happened.
Yeah.
And you kind of pick that up, and most of the game you're like, I don't really understand what this all means, until now where you're like, no, you were all actually human. This is messed up.
Now my question is, would they still have revealed it if you didn't choose it? I guess not.
I don't think so. I mean, they imply it with the last dialogue.
Right, I'm sure.
So it's Pancho.
Hell yeah. You know what's really funny? We were talking, good job Danny Hayes and Jack O'Dell. Heck yeah, that was awesome. And more Danny Hayes, we already thanked you. That's fine. No, but seriously, that, we were just talking a little bit ago how they add a new mechanic in every level, and they did that at the end.
Mm-hmm.
They gave you the mechanic of a choice.
Yep.
And that is so good. Matthew Weeks, in case I missed that. Matthew Weeks, awesome.
I want to talk about that, actually. So there's never a point in this game where there really is any kind of, like, choice. There's no moral decisions being made.
No.
And at the very end, you're presented with that. Now, the argument is, perhaps that's out of place, and it kind of detracts from the conclusion of the game. But maybe on the other side is, maybe it gives the entire game significance. So, what do you think about that?
If you want my opinion, I think, A, that should be our question of the day.
Absolutely.
That's absolutely our question of the day. My honest opinion is, I think it solidifies everything you've done. In my opinion, by you saying, I'm going to give up my life for everything, it means that you traveled this world, met all these people, and you know that they got to live the way they were supposed to live.
Mm-hmm.
They got their humanity back, even if it meant you had to give up yours. And that made all that failing worth it. Like, literally, I don't even feel angry about all those
times.
I feel justified. I am really impressed with Pancho. Like, when we talked about this, because it was really funny, we had a meeting, and Chris was just like, here are the games, and I just picked Pancho because, hell, it's a fun word.
It looked, it was a fun word.
I didn't play
cool.
the game yet. We only saw, like, a clip of it, and I'm like, this is kind of cool. And so Chris gave me his codes to play, and holy crap. I didn't think I would... I didn't think that ending would justify the game as much as it did.
You didn't think you'd be feeling things.
I did not think so. And good on you guys. Seriously.
And I think the overall message of the game is really spot on, too, because the world that we're presented with, it's like that semi-exploration kind
yeah.
of environment. And so our opinions about everything going on in the world are purely based on our perception.
Oh, yeah.
Nothing was ever thrown right at us.
Ever.
So at the very end, our decision feels very personal because it's all based on what we've seen in the world and whether or not we
yeah.
think that our journey to this point is worth sacrificing everything, worth sacrificing ourselves, or worth sacrificing everything we've done and just going back.
Yeah.
So it's...
No,
I actually really like it. And the best thing about the moral of or the message of the game is I think that it's really easy to kind of like... Like, it's malleable, right? Like,
yeah.
the same message can be applied to a million other stories.
Yes.
But
I think what makes this story so special is they were light enough on the dialogue throughout the game.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I mean, it had importance, and now that if I were to replay it, I would understand the importance of every single text of white dialogue now. You know, I would understand.
At least you would have the starting point for it. Right,
exactly. And I just feel like it was very smart to save all the heavy hitting for the end, not really tease much. I would just give you little tastes, and you really wouldn't know
mm-hmm.
whether or not they were humans. You
yeah,
wouldn't.
Yeah.
And that's beautiful. I love this game. Like, no, seriously, like, that ending, that just justified everything for me. Like, literally all the pain I went through in the last 2 hours of trying to beat this game because I couldn't do one jump. I'm not even mad about it anymore. I'm relieved that I got to see this ending. I'm glad I did it on my own. I mean, you helped me.
No.
Like, you helped me get my keystrokes
down. I'm glad I never touched the controller.
But I'm glad you never touched it either. We talked about this at first. Like, usually if I start making a lot of mistakes, I hand it off to Chris. But because we were running through so well up until the end, it's really worth it. Everyone, like, I know you just watched us play this, but you should pick it up and explore this world, because not just us playing it, it doesn't do it enough justice.
And maybe see what that other ending is.
And see what that other ending is, because I don't want to know. I don't even know if I want to pick up the game again to get that other ending. I think I'm so happy.
You don't want to spoil the experience.
I don't think I want to. I think I'll be interested to just keep playing, just get better at platformers, but no.
And there's a lot of other secrets we had yet to explore in this game,
yes,
too.
Yes, so there are a lot.
Yeah, I'd even love to hear from everyone else if you have played this.
Yeah.
What were some of the other secrets that we missed?
That'd be super cool, especially like that one area where you could keep going the other way at the first level.
Yeah.
Like that really far off spot, if it's just more robots or not, or people, really.
So, question of the day. What did you think about the ending? Do you think that having a moral question at the very end, when it wasn't present throughout the rest of the game, do you think that it has a place in a game like this?
It's like a backwards Deus Ex Machina, right?
Kind of, yeah.
Like, instead, it's like, are the machine making the choice.
Yeah, yeah. Instead of a god stepping in and like, fixing everything, it's
you
become that authority.
You become that authority, which is so interesting, because it's all about robots. You just hear Machina, and, you know, I know it's the gods, but, you know, the idea of machines. But no, great job, Delve. Seriously.
Yeah, absolutely.
Delve Interactive, the whole team, awesome.
And thank you, everybody, for watching this whole
Hell
playthrough.
Yeah.
It's been a blast to play through, honestly.
I loved it. I absolutely loved it. I'm excited. Happy this is my first full-time GDPG experience.
Ooh.
So, heck yeah. Are we going to have, like, a little vote thing for the next game like we've done with other videos?
Yeah, so, vote for the next playthrough. It may not be the very next one, because we have to look at what you actually clicked, but we'd still love to
see. Yeah, help us choose.
And even, like, if it's not on here and if you want to see us play a game, then request it, because we listen.
Yeah, we do. That's everything, man.
Yeah. All right, well, thank you, everybody, for watching, and we will see you in the next playthrough.
Yeah, thanks for gaming.
Bye, everybody.
Goodbye.